Okay, let's go to problem number 7. Two Boy Scouts at both ends of a 4.0-meter uniform rod carry 3 pieces of luggage. Okay, so uniform rod. The pieces of luggage weigh 45, 55, and 80 newtons. They are placed in this order at equal distances starting from one end. Okay, so at equal distances, so this one is 4.0 meters. So for them to be at equal distances, there should be one placed at the 0 meter mark and then another placed at the middle at the 2.0 meter mark and then another luggage here placed. Okay, so these are their weights. This is 45, 55, and this one is 80. Okay, they are placed, sorry, this one is 80. They are placed in this order at equal, okay? If the rod weighs, there's only one rod, okay? So if the rod weighs 28 newtons, how much force was exerted by each Boy Scout? So there's a Boy Scout here, and there's another Boy Scout here. Okay, so we do not know. Let's call this F1 and F2. So the FBD diagram would look like this. Okay, there is a force here. That's the weight. This is the force exerted by F1. This is a force exerted by the 55 Newton mass. Okay, let's call this F2. This one as F3. Okay, and then there is the center of gravity. Let's call that F4. And this one upward is F5. Okay, so the values that we know are F2, F3, and F4. We do not know F1 and F5. And there is no fulcrum here, so you have to put an imaginary fulcrum. Our rule is to put an imaginary fulcrum where there is an unknown. Okay, so we put the imaginary fulcrum here in F1. Okay, and then we set the equation for torque. Summation of torque is equal to zero. So of course, there is an unknown here. This is 80 newtons, no? Let that be F6. Okay. How much force were exerted by each Boy Scout? Okay. So if you put the torque here, you have torque 3 will produce clockwise motion. Torque 4 will produce clockwise motion. Torque 6 will produce clockwise motion. And then torque 5 will produce counterclockwise motion. Okay, so from this equation, we would be able to solve F5. Okay, that is the unknown. Okay, so torque 5. So we expand, no? So when you move the rest to the other side of the equation, it looks like this. Then we expand. This is F3 L3, F3 L3, plus F4 L4, plus F6 L6, divide by L5. Okay, we do not know F5. Now F3 is 55 newtons. How far is it? It's going to be at the 2.0 meter mark. F4 is 28 newtons. It's going also at the 2.0 newton mark. F6 is 80 at the end, 4. Okay. Divided by L5, the location of L5 is also 4 meters. Let us find F5. Okay, F5 here. times 4. You will get 121.5. Around 120 newtons. Okay, that's going to be F5. And then what about F1? F1, there are two ways of solving this. You can put an imaginary torque here, okay, and then solve for F1 using this equation, or you can use the summation of torque, summation of forces along the y equal to 0, because we know that the upward forces equals the downward forces. So, or the sum of the forces, pwede rin, it's going to be equal to 0. Okay, so if we do sum of forces along the y equal to 0, you will get positive F1, positive F5. Sila lang yung upward force. The rest, puro downward na. Minus F2, minus F3, minus F4. How many forces do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then F6 is also downward, equal to 0. So, what we do not know now is F1. We leave it at one side of the equation. So, it becomes F2. Plus F3 plus F4 plus F6 minus F5. Okay, so what is F1? Okay, so F2 is 45 newtons. Okay, F3 is 55 newtons. F4 is 28 newtons. F6 is 80 newtons. Minus the one that we got a while back, F5, 121.5. Okay, so the total would be 86.5 newtons. F1 is 86.5 newtons, or approximately 87 newtons if we stick this to 1SF. So these are the two answers that we get. Okay, let's go to the next problem. A non-uniform bar, 5.0 meters long, was used by a class, okay, to hold their exhibits of picture frames. The bar weighs 25 newtons and has its center of gravity 2.0 meters from the bigger end. It was hung at its ends by two ropes. Okay, three frames with weights of 10 newtons, 60 newtons, and 22 newtons are hung in this order at a distance of 1.0 meters from each other, starting from one end. I think this should be starting from the smaller end. What is the tension on each rope that will maintain the horizontal position of the bar? Okay, so non-uniform, so it is tapered like this. Okay, so the center of gravity could be somewhere here. The entire length is 5.0 meters. The bar weighs 25 newtons, so this is where the 25 newtons is acting. F is equal to 25 newtons. We can call this FW, the weight of the non-uniform bar, and has its center of gravity 2.0 meters. So here, 2.0 meters would be the location of the center of gravity. Okay. It was hung at its ends by two ropes. So there is an upward force here and another upward force here. Okay, let's call this F1 and F2. Okay, three frames with weights of 10 newtons, 16, and 22 are hung in this order at a distance of 1.0 meters starting from one end. So starting from one end. Sabi natin, from the smaller end. So this is F3, 10 newtons. Then another meter, you get F4, 16 newtons. And another meter, so this is 1, 2, on the third meter siya, no? So it's acting here. Kasi this is 2 meters, 5 meters. Okay. This would be on the second meter mark. So 5 minus 2. So nandito rin yung F5. F5 is 22 newtons. Okay, so kasi 1 meter, 1 meter, and then the third meter, that is also where your FW is. Okay, so F5 is 22 newtons. What is the tension on each rope that will maintain the horizontal? So what is F1 and F2? We do, we can put the imaginary fulcrum on F1 and then do summation of torque is equal to zero at F1. Okay, so we put here at F1, that's where we put the imaginary fulcrum. Okay, so what are the torques produced? You have FW clockwise. This is counter. This is clockwise. F5 is also clockwise. F4 is also clockwise. F3 is also clockwise. So lahat sila puro negative torque. Okay, so torque 5, torque 4, torque 3. Okay, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then F2 will be positive torque 2. Okay, is equal to 0. So we can solve for torque 2. This is going to give us torque W plus torque 5 plus torque 4 plus torque 3. Okay, and then we expand this. Torque W, we leave torque 2 on one side. Torque W, torque 5 plus torque 4 plus torque 3. Tama. And then we expand this. This is F2 L2 is equal to FW LW plus F5 L5 plus F4 L4 plus F3 L3. Okay. We would like to know F2. So we move L2 to the other side of the equation. So F2 is equal to what is the weight of the object? It is 25 newtons. What is the location? From the fulcrum, it's 2.0 meters. And then F5 is 22 on the same spot, 2.0 meters. F4 is 60 newtons. Where is it located? It's going to be 2 plus 1, 3 meters. Okay, that is F4, L4. And then yung F3 naman, F3 is 10 newtons. How far is it? F3 is 5.0 meters. Divided by 5.0 meters. Okay. 1 meter apart pala sila na. So, F3 is 1 meter apart. So ito pala. Sorry, this is the location of F5. Okay, so F5, let's change the location. It's 3.0 meters away. Okay, 3.0. So this is the correct. So ito yung F5. I'll put it here. Okay, so F2 is equal to 25 times 2 plus 22 times 2 plus 16 times 3 plus 10 times 5 divided by 5. You will get 38.4. So this is 38.4 newtons, or approximately 38 newtons. Okay. And then we do summation of forces along the y is equal to 0. Okay, so we want to solve for F1. Pwede na natin i-set up yung equation agad F1. Kasi ito, F1 is upward, diba? So, this will give us positive F1. Okay, Okay, negative 25, negative 22, negative, what is F5? F5 is 16. Oh, wait. Negative 25, negative 22. F4 is negative 16, negative 10, plus 38.4. That is F2. Okay, so what is F1? Ah, okay, so we have to change the sign because we're adding, no? Plus, plus. We move it to the other side of the equation. So plus 16 plus 10, this should be minus 38.4. Okay, so 25 plus 22 plus 16 plus 10 minus 38.4, you will get 34.6. 34.6 newtons or 35 newtons. Okay, these are the forces exerted by each rope. Okay, so ito yon yung nandito, yung force ng F1 at saka ng F2. So F1 is 35 newtons and then F2 is 38 newtons. Okay, mas malaki yung load, ang tension sa F2 kasi mas marami ang mga weights na nandoon sa side niya. Okay, let's go to problem number 9. Problem number 9, a 30-ton uniformly paved bridge spans 1/4 kilometer. Okay, 1/4 kilometer, that is 250 meters. Okay, 1/4 kasi is 0.25. Okay, so let us draw. This is the bridge. It's 250 meters. 20 meters from one end of the bridge, a 5-ton truck is parked. Okay, so ito lagay natin dito yung 5-ton truck. Okay, and it is located 20 meters from one end. 30 meters from the other end, from here, there is a 3-ton car. So from here to here, and this is 30 meters. Okay. How much force does the support at each end of the bridge exert? Kasi merong mga support na dito and dito. So we do not know. Let us call this F1. And we do not know F2, yung support. Etong kotse, let's call this F3. And this one is F4. And yung weight ng bridge, it's 30 tons. Let's call that FW. 30 tons. So everything is already in tons. We don't have to convert. So put the imaginary fulcrum on F1. Sabi natin, you always put the imaginary fulcrum where there is an unknown. Okay, so, and then we do summation of torque. So summation of torque is equal to 0. So wala na si F1. Si 3.0 ton happens at the, okay, this 3.0 ton will produce a clockwise motion. So negative torque 3. Ito, clockwise motion, negative torque W. F4 will also be clockwise motion. And then torque 2 will produce a counterclockwise motion. Okay, let's call that. This is equal to, torque 2 is equal to 0. Ayan. So we do not know torque 2, so we leave it alone on one side. Yung F2 ni torque 2, hindi natin alam, no? We leave it on one side of the equation. The rest, move them to the other side. Okay. Torque 3 is F3L3 plus FWLW plus F5L5. Okay. So F2 divide everything by L2. Okay. We plug in the values. What is F3? F3 is 3.0 ton. How far is it from the imaginary fulcrum? It's 30 meters. FW is 200, sorry, 30 tons. How far is it from the imaginary fulcrum? It is on the 125 meter mark kasi nasa gitna, geometric center. No? And then F5 is 5 tons. How far is it? So 250 minus 20, this will give you 230 meters. Okay? Divide everything by how far is F2? F2 is on the 250 meter mark. Okay, so we can compute for F2. So L2 is 250 meters, no? So 30 times 3 times 30 plus 5 times 230. Okay, the support of F2 is 19.96 tons, or around 20 tons. Okay, mas magaan yung sa kanya. Mas mabigat dapat kay F2 kasi yung mabibigat nandito on the right side. 5 tons yung nandito. Okay, so the summation of forces along the Y is equal to 0. So upward si F1, tsaka si F2 upward. Downward si F3, downward si FW, downward si F4. This is equal to 0. So, we do not know F2. So, F2 is equal to F3 plus FW plus F4 minus F1, the one that we solved a while back. So, F2 is equal to, si F3 is 3 tons. CFW is 30 tons. CF4, 5.0 tons. And then CF1, 19.96 tons. Okay, so what is F2? 30 plus 3 plus 5 minus 19.96. This will give us 18.04 tons. Or 18 tons. This would be F2. Okay, so the force supported at each end for this given instance would be 18 tons and 20 tons. Okay, let's go to number 10. Two construction workers carry a 500 Newton load of cement using a pole 2.55 meters long and weighing 20 Newtons. That's the weight of the pole, no? Yung 20 Newtons. The load is placed at the middle of the pole, sa gitna. Okay, one worker supports the pole at one end, and the question is, where should the heavier worker support the pole if he is to shoulder part of the load in the ratio 3:2 with the other worker? Okay. Okay. So let us This is our interpretation. It's uniform pole, so 2.55 meters long, and the load is placed at the middle. So load is equal to 500 newtons. And also at the middle, you have the weight of the pole, which is 20 newtons. Okay? One worker supports the pole at one end, where should the heavier worker support? So see, the heavier, so this one, the lighter, let's call this F1, the smaller, okay, yung lighter, let's call this F1. Syempre, pag support, it's upward. Ang question is, ano yung F2? Where is the location of F2? Okay, so let us set up the equation, sum of torque. So we do not know F1 and F2. Let's place the imaginary fulcrum here, okay, F1. So the sum of torque is equal to 0. There are 3 torques that will be produced by FW, FL, the load, and F2. Okay, FW and FL, they are clockwise motion. So torque W, FL is torque L, the load. Okay, and then the torque produced by F2 would be positive because it's going to produce a counterclockwise torque. Okay, so this is equal to zero. We set up the equation first. This is negative 20. That's the force. The location is at the center. What is 2.55 divided by 2? This will give us 1.275. Okay, so this is 1.275. And then torque L, we place it. TL is 20, 500 newtons, and then we place it at the middle din siya, 1.275. And then plus torque 2. Torque 2, we do not know torque 2, but it is located 2.55 meters. So, and ito yung ating equation. Okay? Is equal to 0. Okay, so we can solve for torque 2. Oh, wait. We do not know also the location of F2. Let us put it as L2. Okay? So, two unknowns. We cannot solve this equation. So, we need to solve sum of forces along the Y is equal to 0. There are, you have upward CF1, upward CF2, downward CFW, tapos downward CFL. This is equal to 0. But there's a relationship. Sabi niya, 3 is to 2. So, we multiply F1 by 3. This is equal to twice of F2. Okay? So, we can make a substitution. Instead of writing F1, okay, we can solve for this. No? F1 is equal to 2/3 F2. Okay? Kasi mas maliit yung force niya. So, 2/3 F2. Plus F2 minus FW, the weight of the 20 newtons, minus 500 newtons. This is equal to 0. Okay, so now we have solved for F2. This is going to be 3 over 3. 5 over 3 F2 is equal to 520 newtons. Okay, so F2 is equal to 520 times 3 divided by 5, 312. See, F2 is 312 newtons. So, we can substitute 312 newtons here and we would be able to solve for L2. Okay, let's do that. So, L2 is equal to 20 times 1.275 plus 500 times 1.275 divided by 312 newtons. So the location is from the fulcrum, it should be 2.125 meters. Okay, so it's from here. From here, it should be 2.125 meters. Yung location niya. Okay? Thank you.